Today's Snow Motion Chairlift interview is with Hunter Schlepper.
Who is Hunter Schlepper? Hunter, I want to hear about your whole career and your passion for the outdoors and the sport of skiing.
Well, I started out ski racing, basically going up my whole life right here in Vail, and went on to the U.S. ski team, had some knee injuries, started kind of pursuing other things like snow skating, snowboarding, a lot of wakeboarding in the summer, just kind of pushing my athletic skills to the very max. And basically nowadays I'm just trying to get outside, hang out, do as much outdoor activities as possible.
I was asking a whole bunch of teenagers, who should I do my next chairlift interview with? And they said, Hunter Schlepper, he is so cool. And I think they all look up to you because you do it all and you live the life you want to lead.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, mixing it up every day between skiing and snowboarding, wakeboarding, it keeps the mind fresh. You don't get so burned out doing one thing. Like, when I was younger, I got a little burned out ski racing because it was all 100% that, where nowadays I'm doing 10 different sports in a week and it's just totally so much better.
Do you ever miss maybe the opportunity or that you could have had? I mean, you could have been a world champion. I mean, do you ever think about that because you were so good?
I definitely do. I look at all my friends that are having great success every day and I look and, oh yeah, I used to beat these kids, race with them all the time. And it's, looking back, that part of it was awesome, but the whole being forced to do the other stuff, like the U.S. ski team wanted me to live in Park City, Utah all summer, where I can't be a professional wakeboarder like I am doing that. They wanted me to pick an event or pick a sport, and I felt like that was a waste of talent.
Yeah. So tell us about your wakeboarding.
Yeah, all summer I spend it wakeboarding down in Florida, up in Minnesota, Texas, basically wherever it possibly could lead me.
Okay, now it looks like this is a wakeboard on snow. What are you carrying?
This is a snow skate. It's basically a skateboard on snow, leashed in, but no bindings.
I've never seen that.
Yeah, it's definitely different. This is the second year Vail's allowed it on the mountain, so it's kind of a new thing around here.
So, but you were a ski racer, but then you were a big mountain skier. So you went from ski racing to big mountain skiing to snowboarding.
Yeah, I've always kind of snowboarded. I've snowboarded since I was six, so it's always been there, but mostly ski. And then once the ski racing thing stopped, 100% of my time was focused on big mountain.
Okay, now I couldn't find you yesterday, and then everyone's saying, oh, he's in the backcountry. Where in the backcountry did you go?
Well, I spent a lot of time up on Vail Pass, up on my snowmobiles with my brother and a couple of my friends, and just exploring around, a lot of filming, a lot of avalanche encounters, stuff like that out in the backcountry.
So have you learned to be good in the backcountry? Do you know
definitely,
the dangers?
Definitely. Not every time we've been out there, 200 plus days on the backcountry, not one person that we've been with has ever been caught in a slide. We've been around quite a few, so we definitely try to take it safe.
Where else do you go, and what else do you like to do?
Basically, wherever snow's flying. I've been down south to Telluride, Whistler up in Canada. It's awesome, California. But for everyday skiing, Vail's probably my most favorite, and then Whistler obviously comes after that.
Hunter, I read one of your Facebook posts, which caught me, and I thought, wow, it was just so, it was so profound because it talked about your passion for the outdoors and the choice you made to live in the mountains and have this lifestyle.
Yeah, I mean, I could go into a city and I could go get a 9-to-5 job, be a weekend warrior and not do it.
A weekend warrior.
I could definitely live in the mountains and just, I'm not gonna make as much money, but it's definitely be enjoying 100% of my life, not sacrificing anything for something else.
All right, so you work right at the base of the mountain at your dad's shop, which is so cool.
Definitely, yeah. Grew up there. It was the first snowboard shop in Vail, so I've been riding every single day, 100 plus days a year, my entire life, so.
I think you've earned so much respect from these kids because you're so good at everything you do.
Yeah.
And it's just like, you know, going out there and free skiing. You're going out there and hitting it hard.
Definitely. I'm almost at the point in life where it's easier for me to be on snow, it doesn't matter what it is, than it is for me to walk, so.
So, are you on snow every single day?
Definitely, I have. I think this is 100 days in a row right now.
Wow, what would you do? What would your body do if it didn't go up on the mountain or go on the snowmobile?
I don't know. What would my brain do?
Yeah, what would your brain do? Skiing is stimulating, yeah.
Yeah, it is. It's closest thing to heaven, you could say. I mean, being able to go down on snow, nothing like that.
Okay, well, what a treat to have you take a run with us.
Yeah, definitely. Thank you.
We can keep up, can't we, guys? Let's go. Thanks, Hunter.